so low. People look at me and they know. They can tell something is wrong. Like I don't belong. Well, staring through a window, standing outside there just to happen to catch.
I'm here with James Morrison, who has a terrific sound, beautiful voice, nice smile.
Thank you.
Tell me, who inspires you? What are some of your inspirations?
Well, all the old like soul singers definitely were a big influence, purely because they sang with so much passion. And I was never into, like, you know, growing up around like 90s kind of dance music, late 80s. I hate new romantic music. So my mum had a lot of soul records and Van Morrison records and great singer songwriters. And that was kind of what I was brought up on, really, just soul music and good singer-songwriters, yeah.
What were you trying to achieve with this album?
I just wanted to give a little bit of insight into, to give people a reason. Like, I feel like I sing a certain way because of the way I was brought up, and it's more about the emotion in the music rather than kind of my husky voice or whatever, you know. I want to rely on being honest in my songwriting, and honest to the point where, you know, every time you sing the line, it brings it back to you when you feel it, you know. I mean, I just wanted to write an album full of good songs that people could relate to, that they could sing along to, and not just the ordinary lyric of kind of being with somebody or in a relationship all the time. I wanted it to be about people who were important to me, my friends, or just little stories that people could relate to, you know? And that was kind of it, really.
Tell us the story behind Wonderful World.
Oh, Wonderful World, yeah. It's basically about this guy you're seeing on a bus. I always try to look for things that maybe people won't see or kind of... it's kind of about that guy who... He was a deaf guy trying to be really over-the-top affectionate with people. And he was upsetting a lot of people. I laughed at it a little bit, but I did kind of, deep down, I really felt sorry for him. I thought, you know, he's only hugging people, you know, don't get offended. Like, why is that such a weird thing, you know? I wanted to write a song that would reflect that and kind of, you know, cheer him up at the same time, kind of a more optimistic version of what I saw, really, you know, and that was kind of it.
Any story behind Last Goodbye?
The Last Goodbye? The Last Goodbye was kind of a songwriting idea more than a personal kind of anguish or kind of saying goodbye to someone for the last time. I did think of moving out of home. I did think of, you know, as the last goodbye, kind of, okay, that's it, I'm moving out of home. But yeah, it's kind of more of an idea based around, saying that it will be the last goodbye to somebody.
Hear the stories behind the songs themselves.
Definitely.
And tell me about the album. What's the title? Is it Undiscovered?
Undiscovered, yeah.
And why that title?
Well, at first, it kind of, I didn't have an album title, and I wrote the song Undiscovered, which was about a friend of mine who, he was like into drugs and he's all right now, but yeah, he was into drugs at the time. And he was kind of saying, you know, I really want to be good at something, you know. And I did feel for him. I said to him, you know, you can be good at something. You just need to find what it is. And he was like, well, what is it going to be? Like, I think, you know, it sort of stayed with me. And I think a lot of people, you know, even my brother, he is such a talented kid at everything that he wants to be. He can skate, he can swim, he can do all sorts, you know. And I think there's a lot of people out there that, you know, can be good at something. But they just don't know what it is, and it was kind of that idea of, no, you're not lost, you're just undiscovered, you know, like a positive kind of way of saying, you know, you haven't lost it, or you know, you still got something there. And a lot of the songs on the album did reflect that kind of undiscovered fulfillment, or kind of, you know, I got a song on the album called One Last Chance, and You Give Me Something is quite a mean love song, so yeah, it's like that undiscovered kind of fulfillment or passion or love or kind of, yeah, that's, and plus, you know, I wanted it to sound like an old 70s album, you know, like, so it might be undiscovered from that time or kind of, you know,
a lot of 70s influence.
Yeah, well, 60s, 70s, yeah, early, just real sounding music, you know, proper instruments and the way that they recorded it live, and, you know, like the old Marvin Gaye records.
You're by your tongue, you don't know why, where I'm coming from. But in my head, I'm close to you, we're in the rain, so searching for the sun. You're thinking I'm wondering and high, we're all locked up inside. I just want you to find me. I'm not lost, I'm not lost, just undiscovered. When we're alone, we're all the same, teach it that. You see the look that's on my face, you might think I'm out of place. I'm not lost, no, no, just undiscovered.
Hey, first single was You Give Me Something.
Okay.
The mean love song.
Why did you choose that song?
Because I just thought it wasn't like a, it's just kind of like, I felt like it was a token song to the album. It's a nice little sweet tune that will sit with you, but it's not kind of too deep straight away, you know. It's just a little taster. Yeah, that's kind of why, really.
Now I'm going to put you on the spot. Okay. Now, when you look at, no, don't get nervous. Don't get nervous at all. There is a lot of music out there, so I'm sure that you kind of have to find your niche, and I'm going to ask you, my question to you is, what is your niche? How do you fit into what is not there and fill that void?
How do I fit into what is not there? Well, I mean, the only way that I kind of tried to do it in my head was, yeah, that what I was saying about being honest, and I think if you're being pure honesty, you can't escape it. You know, it's honest, and you either get it or you don't. You know, and that's kind of how I felt about making the album. I just wanted to make an album that I felt like I was making an honest reflection of how I can feel about things, and that was all I did really. I wanted to write an album full of good songs that would stand up to the music that I liked, but also it had my own thing on it, you know. And that was the only way that I could kind of fit into that niche that maybe is missing is the honesty in music that was lacking at the time, I felt.
Is there any song in particular from your set that you played today that you would say, you know, this is James Morrison, this is me introducing myself to the world? What song would that be? I'm setting you up for a clip.
Okay, it'll probably be Wonderful World, yeah.
Okay.
Definitely, because I mean, I think even though it's about that guy, I could relate to a lot of it, you know. I could relate to kind of being a bit of an outsider. I was a bit of an outsider at school, you know, because of situations at home and stuff. But yeah, I could definitely relate to it. And Wonderful World.
So okay, you're checking out A Wonderful World with James Morrison. The album is Undiscovered. And it's coming out, what, March 13th?
March 13th.
Check that out on Binside TV. Thanks for being on Binside. Check it out.
I've been down so low, people love me and they know. They can tell something is wrong, like I don't belong. Well, staring through a window. standing outside, they're just too happy to care tonight. Wanna be like them, but I'll mess it up again. I tripped on my way in, got kicked outside, everybody is sore. And I know that it's a wonderful world, but I can't feel it right now. Well, I thought that I was doing well, but I just wanna cry. So full of love, it just comes spilling out.